श्याम एव परम रूपम बरा मधुपुरी बरा श्याम एवो परम रूपम बरा मधुपुरी बरा वयो कैशर कम धेयम अद्व एव परो रसः श्याम एवो परम रूपम बरा मधुपुरी बरा वयो कैशर कम धेयम अद्व एव परो रसः। सिसिला भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद टेलिंग इन दिस वेरी लाइफ यू कैन गेट कृष्णा बट देयर इज सम कंडीशन इफ यू कैन फॉलो अ बोनाफाइड स्पिरिचुअल मैस्टर प्रॉपरली इफ यू कैन डू सेवा प्रॉपरली then you can go to Krishna. Actually, there is two kind of seva, twofold. One is bani seva, one is body seva, twofold. If you do only body seva, if you don't care for bani seva, then you can fall down. If you can do bani seva and bopu seva both parallel, simultaneously, bani seva and bopu seva, you are giving prasadam to Gurudev, you are doing different kind of seva, massage everything, giving medicine, taking him to latrine, doing everything. But if you can do actual bani seva, then you can survive. Otherwise, you can fall down. If we can go, if we look into the statistics of Gauriya Math, we can find the same case. 99% devotees, those who are engaged in Guru Seva, I mean physical Seva, but they don't care for bani seva. They all fall down. They cannot do. Now, point is that how we can understand who is doing actual guru seva? How we can understand that who is doing actual guru seva? How we can understand? As per scripture, I mean, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada telling, if you are really engaged in Guru Seva, if you are really engaged in Vaishnava Seva, if you are really engaged in Guru Seva, then all the qualities of Guruji, all the Siddhanta, all the qualities of Guruji supposed to come inside you. Automatically, it's an automatic factor. If I am serving Srila Bhakti Pramod Puriyoshi Maharaj, I am going to get all his qualities, his siddhanta, all his power coming inside me. You can feel. If no power coming, no siddhanta, then you must be sure that kripa not coming to him. Kripa not coming to him at false. Everybody thinks he is enjoying Guru Kripa, he is enjoying Guru Kripa. But if you look into the matter very deeply, you can find no, he is not enjoying Guru Kripa. I can give one or two examples, you can understand. Actually, Shankaracharya, you heard the name of Shankaracharya? He preached Mayavadi, Mayavad Siddhanta, but he himself is great Vaishnava. Shankaraha Sakshat Shankaraha. Who is Shankar? Mahadev, Lord Shankar. He came as Shankaracharya. So there cannot be any mistake in his philosophy. There cannot be any mistake in his philosophy. But as per the direction of Supreme Lord, he was bound to speak Mayavad, Mayavad Bhashya. But he himself singing, Ha Krishna. Bhajo Govindam, Bhajo Govindam, Govindam Bhajo Muramate, Sangprapte Sannihite Kale, Nahi Nahi Rakshati Dunkriya Karane. Was speaking? Shankaracharya, very secretly advising everybody. But I am speaking Mayavad philosophy, okay. But inside my heart, Krishna Bhakti is there, full. So I am singing and dancing. Bhajo Govindam, Bhajo Govindam. You are foolish. You try to worship Krishna. Bhajo Govindam. Then you can come out successful. Otherwise, no way. No way. Actually, Shankaracharya, one day, this Himalayan place, you know, Sharada Ashram, you know. If you go to Badrikashram, you know? Badrikashram, in the way of Badrikashram, just 4-5 kilometers before, you can get one ashram of Mayavadi. It's called Sharada Ashram. That time Shankaracharya was there with all his full troops, I mean all disciples. They are very happy. We are going to get a nice philosophy from Gurudev every day because it's a very hilly place, nice. No noise, no disturbance. Very nice Himalayan place. So Gurudev speaking Harikatha daily. One day, morning time, Shankaracharya sitting in Basasam, in chair. He is supposed to speak Harikatha, but he is not speaking. He is supposed to speak Harikatha, but he is not speaking. All disciples speaking, Gurudev, start. You can start Harikatha. You can start, everybody coming. You can start Harikatha, everybody coming. Gurudev saying, well, one devotee, he is supposed to come. Let him come. His name is Padmapad. He is the servant of Shankaracharya. He is washing clothes of Shankaracharya, giving prasadam. So that time he went to wash the clothes of Gurudeva in a spring water coming. There is went to wash clothes. He is supposed to come. And Gurudev saying, let Padmapad come, then I can speak. Then all disciples, they are speaking. Maharaj, Padmapad is foolish. Padmapad is foolish. Padmapad is not educated. Padmapad is not educated. He cannot understand your speech. You speak in front of us. We are all educated. We are knowing all scriptural, we are versed in scriptural analysis. You can speak in front of us. Gurudev look at them. Well, let him come. Again speaking, let him come. Then they wonder, why Gurudev waiting for them? Waiting for that foolish person who is Padmapad, is not educated. Then Gurudev give power to Padmapad. Gurudev translate power to Padmapad. Padmapad coming after washing clothes, with all clothes and water he is coming and speaking all Vedanta Sutra, like memorized. He is coming and reciting all Vedanta Sutra. And all people looking at, who is reciting Vedanta Sutra? Oh, Padmapad reciting, oh my God. We thought Padmapad is illiterate, but by the grace of Gurudev, he's speaking all Vedanta Sutra is speaking. Gurudev looking at them. See, that is called Guru Kipa. If you are enjoying full Guru Kipa, then you can speak Harikatha. Otherwise you cannot speak Harikatha. Harikatha is not a material thing. You see? Somebody can put question before Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada. Somebody can put question. And somebody already put a question. That Prabhupada, you always speak about Guru Seva, Guru Seva. What Guru Seva you do? Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj not taking any seva from you. He is staying exclusively in a kutia, always doing madhukari. He is taking or living on madhukari. No clothes, nothing. You are staying in Mayapur. So, what seva you do? He put question. Because people, they are idiot, you see, foolish. They don't understand what is Guru Tata. They don't understand. That's why they go for argument. They always go for argument. I already told logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. But they always depend about their logical interpretation. Oh, I am very intelligent. Really, you are intelligent. You are intelligent according to your own estimate. You are intelligent. But not you are intelligent as per the estimation of Gurudev and Vaishnava. You are not intelligent because in Bhagavatam it is written, who is actually intelligent? Uddhav putting question before Krishna, please tell me who is actually intelligent. Krishna giving nice answer to him. Esha buddhimatam buddhi manishasa manishinam yat satyam anrite neha martena apnati amritam. Krishna speaking to Uddhav. Esha buddhimatam buddhi manishasa manishinam yat satyam anrite neha martena apnati amritam. Krishna giving answer to Uddhav. Uddhav, he is actually intelligent. Who can come into a conclusion that this life is only and only for Hari Bhajan, not for other purpose. This my life is only for Hari Bhajan, not for any other purpose. He is actually intelligent. Otherwise, he cannot be called intelligent. Understand? So somebody can put question before Prabhupada, what kind of seva you have done of Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj? They are so foolish, so ignorant, they can put some argument. What seva you have done? Yes, really. Actually, as per scriptural analysis, if you can speak Harikatha, if you can write Harikatha, Bani Seva is most important. It was the desire of Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj. That you must preach the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in front of thousands of people. That big seva Prabhupada has done. In the life of Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj, we see what is written in Srimad Bhagavatam. We can find all these written documents in applied form. In the life of Sri Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj. What is written in Srimad Bhagavatam, we can find all in applied form in the life of Srila Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj. So he is Bhagavatam. This is book Bhagavatam and he is a living embodiment of Bhagavatam. Bhakti. So it was the standing instruction of Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj. You must preach the teachings of Gauranga Mahaprabhu all over the world. So Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami already have done in his life. Same thing. You don't know actually Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj was very much in favor of Shuddha Siddhanta, pure devotion. If somebody coming to Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj and somebody coming to Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj, Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj, he is studying Bimala Prasad, I mean Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, he is doing this and that. Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj become very angry. Why? You don't like? He is speaking also pure Harikatha. He is showing you the way of pure devotion. He is showing you the way of pure devotion. You don't like it? You have come to me to lodge a complaint with him? Complaint against him? You don't know? One day, Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj invite all devotees throughout Navadvip Dham. You all come, there is big bandara, there is big feast in where? In Jogapit. You all come, big invitation, big feast there. Then after there is a devotees, they are all coming to take prasadam. Oh, nice big. Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj is also there. And Harikatha going on, big, they are big Maharaj just speaking or Harikatha. Big Harikatha going on, up to 3 p.m., 4 p.m. And those devotees, they are thinking, where is prasadam? Many people coming, where is prasadam? There is no prasadam. They say, big bandara here, big prasadam. But there is no prasadam. We don't find any cooking, nothing going on. And after 5 o'clock, Gaurakishore Baba laughing in front of those devotees, coming with some sweets, and he is distributing. He said, there is big bandara of Harikatha. There is big bandara of Harikatha. Today you find big bandara of Harikatha. You take this sweet. For this Harikatha, I invited you. This is actual bandara. This is actual bandara. So I invited you. So they became very surprised. Now actually this is actually bandara. Because Harikatha going on. Actually Harikatha is bandara. At the time of Prabhupada, they used to speak 5 hours, 6 hours, 7 hours at a stage. Gopurnim day specially, whole day Harikatha. Srila Bhaktivedanta Madhava Goswami Maharaj, when he used to go to different place for preaching, I heard 4 times they speak Harikatha. Madhava Goswami Maharaj, when going to Punjab here, there, I heard he is giving four sitting, morning time, then around 10:30, after that noon, 3 p.m., night time, 4 sitting. They are always speaking Harikatha. One after another, Harikatha, they are speaking, actually. Now, point is that I started with a nice topics, but I was bound to speak these points because without Guru Seva and Vaishnava Seva, we cannot achieve Bhakti at all. So what about Rasa Tatra? I can also discuss tomorrow about it. Actually, if you think in cool brain, without Rasa, we cannot live. Nobody in this material world can live without Rasa. Without Rasa, we cannot live. Any animal, any creature in this material world, they cannot live without Rasa. They cannot live. But that Rasa is Jada Rasa, material Rasa. 5 fields are there of enjoyment. Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha. You know, sound, speech, Shabda, Sparsha, sound, natural beauty, any kind of, Shabda, Sparsha, touching, Rupa, Rasa, taste, and Gandha, smell. 5 different fields of enjoyment there, already in this material world. If you like to enjoy, you can go and enjoy. Enjoyment is open, market is open before you. You can go and enjoy as you like. But that become a bondage for you. इन गीता भगवान से जे ही संस्पर्श जा भोगा दुख जनय इवते आद्यंत बंतु कंतियो न तेषु रमते वदाह। दिस माइक्रोफोन इज नॉट गुड, यू कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड प्रॉपरली, यू कैन गिव दिस। जे ही संस्पर्श जा भोगा दुख जनय इवते आद्यंत बंतु कंतियो न तेषु रमते वदाह। Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, if you are really intelligent, those who are really intelligent, they never go for sensual enjoyment. Those who are really intelligent, they never go for sensual enjoyment, because this is a kind of bondage for you. Sensual enjoyment means bondage. In Bhagavatam, so many instant there, it is written there, so many example there in Bhagavatam, if you can understand. इन गीता भगवान ऑलरेडी सेइंग इज गुड, जे ही संस्पर्श जा भोगः दुख जनय एवते आद्यंत बंतु कंतियो न तेषु रमते बुधा। Those who are really intelligent, they never go for sensual enjoyment. This is a kind of bondage for you. There are five kinds of fields there of enjoyment. You are at liberty, you can go and enjoy. That's up to you. But ultimately, you are going to fall into bondage. Nobody can save you. Big problem for you. Nobody can save you. Big problem. Actually, point is that I told one nice sloka before my speech. What the sloka is, you can memorize this sloka. Sam eva param rupam bara madhupuri bara bayo kaisa rukam dheyam आद्यो एव परो रसः। यू कैन रिमेम्बर श्याम एव परम रूपम बरा मधुपुरी बरा बयो कैसरकम धेयम आद्यो एव परो रसः। आद्यो एव परो रसः। व्हेन श्रीमन महाप्रभु वेंट टू इलाहाबाद, यू कैन रिमेम्बर महाप्रभु वेंट टू इलाहाबाद। And in Allahabad, Ballavacharya ji, came to invite Sriman Mahaprabhu, please come to my room. Then Mahaprabhu was invited, and Srila Rupa Goswami Pad and Anupam, the junior god brother of Rupa Goswami Pad. Ballavacharya took all of them in a boat. They took them in Arailgram, mane a village name Arailgram, that just that side of Ganga Jamuna Saraswati confluence, that side of Ganga. There Mahaprabhu was invited and went there. He reached there, he was sitting there. Suddenly, by the desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, one pure Brahmin, Vaishnav, coming to him to take darshan. He paid dandavat to Mahaprabhu and he stand up. And Mahaprabhu, he is knowing everything. His name was? You can remember, I already speak. You cannot remember. Mahaprabhu telling, please speak something about pure devotion. Please speak something. Please speak something. He started speaking. There are different forms of Krishna. Krishna appear in different form. Sometime Ram, Nrisimha, Varaha, Krishna. Which form you like, which is the best? Then he is speaking Shyam eva param rupam. Shyam Sundar, who is staying inside Vrindavan. That form is excellent. And which dham you like much? Which dham is excellent? Mathura. Yeah. And Krishna doing his so many leela, childhood leela, boyhood leela, different leela. Which leela you like? But when Krishna is too young, I mean teenager age, when 14 or 15, 16 year age, that age is excellent leela. That time Krishna manifests very excellent leela. Sam eva param rupam bara madhupuri bara or bayo kaishurakam dhyam. When Krishna is too young, that age we can meditate, we can concentrate our mind unto the lotus feet of that Krishna who is doing rasa, that. And which rasa is the best? Then he is telling adya eva pararasa, adya eva pararasaha. Original rasa, prime rasa, original dress rasa is the best of all, because all rasa, because ultimate rasa is madhur rasa, ultimate rasa, and all rasa coming from step by step, understand. His name is Raghupati Upadhyay. In front of Raghupati Upadhyay, Mahaprabhu speak something about pure devotion. Mahaprabhu knowing he is in the line of pure devotion, he started speaking. Mahaprabhu become very happy. Oh, you are teaching me a nice thing. Mahaprabhu memorized this thing. Actually, Mahaprabhu speaking, but it seems he is speaking. Actually, all rasa, I mean aprakita rasa, transcendental rasa, ultimate limit, ultimate goal is madhurasa. But this material world, you can find, this is called jara rasa, material rasa. It's all rasa there in this, prevailing in this material world. This is called jara rasa. Anyway, without rasa, you cannot live. In some or other way, you are going to enjoy some rasa. Without rasa, you cannot live. No creature, even one mosquito, that mosquito also like to live more and more time. If you want to kill him, you fly. He also like to take the taste of new blood. He like to suck blood, nice blood. So he also like to say, but that mosquito also like to live on. That's why without rasa you cannot live. But one thing very important, this material world is the perverted reflection of the transcendental world. This material world is the perverted reflection of the transcendental world. In transcendental world, madhur rasa is excellent, but this is perverted reflection of that material world. So here, if you have an illicit relation with one woman, then it's very, very dangerous. Everybody can criticize you. Why? Because this is dangerous. It's very dangerous and useless. Why? Because that rasa is excellent there, and that the same rasa is very dangerous here, because perverted reflection. Suppose you are standing in front of a lake, here lake water, you are standing here. If you look into water, you can find one your figure. Huh? You can find one picture, but that picture is just opposite. Your head is down, your leg is up. Whereas now you are standing here, your head is up, your leg is down. But if you look into that picture, you can find the leg is up and head is down. Understand? So, Shantarasa, mellow of, you know, tranquility. Shantarasa, Dasa, Savitasi, Shanta, Dasya, Shakya, friendship. After that, Vatsalya. After that, Madhur. So it is in this order. Here is Madhur, up, down. See, if you look into water, you can find just opposite. I mean that Madhuras is excellent here in the transcendental world, but there is dangerous. Understand my point? So, first of all, we must understand what is rasa. Everybody interested about rasa. They discuss so many things about rasa. So I like to discuss some preliminary thing about rasa. Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur advised us so many things about rasa tattva. If you can go through one book, that book is named Bhakti Vinod Bani Vaibha. If somebody can translate this book into English, Bhakti Vinod Bani Vaibhav. If somebody can translate this book into English, then you can dance. Nobody interested to translate this book. This book is very dangerous. You can know all actual Siddhanta from this. All 100% Siddhanta. Bhaktivinoda Thakur in his whole life, giving advice to some many devotees, they are putting question, Bhaktivinoda answering. It was in written form. In his whole life, Bhaktivinoda all advice in written form. It was compiled into that book. An excellent book. That name is Bhakti Vinod Bani Vaibhav. Bhaktivinoda Thakur disappeared in the year of 1914. Before Athayatra, this year, the Purushottam Vrata, so 1 month gapping. Actually, usually, that tithi, that actually date, when Bhaktivinoda Thakur disappeared, that date is after the Gundicha Mandir Marjan, we clean Gundicha temple, just previous day of Gundicha Mandir temple cleaning. But this year, actually, Purushottam Vrata, due to Purushottam Vrata, there is a big gapping, actual 1 month gapping. Throughout 1 month, we observe Purushottam Vrata. That's why we find that tithi is gone, left behind. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur lived this material world in 1914. After Bhaktivinoda Thakur going, somebody coming and giving a protest note in front of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada. They all speaking, Prabhupada, you are always against Rasa Tattva, you are so strict. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur was more liberal about this matter. We saw him, he invited so many people from different parts of Bengal. He used to hear Rasa Tattva Kirtan from Shantipur, here, there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to invite them. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to invite them. We saw Bhaktivinoda Thakur sitting in a chair nicely. He is doing Harinam and they are doing Kirtan, nice Rasa Tattva Kirtan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur hearing. Bimala Prasad Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur become very angry. Yes, just Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone, now you are coming to me to fight with me regarding this matter. That Bhaktivinoda Thakur was in favor of your Sahajya Kirtan. Now Bhaktivinoda Thakur just gone, 1914. And you are giving a nice note that Bhaktivinoda Thakur was in favor of Sahajya Kirtan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur in his whole life never he approved any kind of Sahajya Kirtan. But you are speaking, giving example that you saw Bhaktivinoda Thakur sitting in chair or Sahajya Kirtan coming and doing Sahajya Kirtan, and you all saw Bhaktivinoda Thakur hearing? Foolish! Bhaktivinoda Thakur was very clever. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was very clever. He know. If somebody is speaking pure Siddhanta, you are not coming to him to hear. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to arrange this kind of Sahajya Kirtan so that you can come and attend that Kirtan and you can find Bhaktivinoda Thakur sitting and doing Harinam. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur not hearing even a single word. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, his attention is not there. His attention is not there in Kirtan, Sahajya Kirtan. He is in deep meditation in Krishna Leela. He is doing Harinam. He is passing away into this Krishna Leela. But you see, he is sitting in front of all people. He is hearing all Sahajya Kirtan. Not at all. Foolish. Actually, those who are demigods, they also cannot understand the mood of Vaishnava. Those who are demigods, they also cannot understand the mood of Vaishnava. So how you can understand the mood of Vaishnava? In his whole life, Bhaktivinoda Thakur always advised about pure devotion. Nowhere you can find a single instance where Bhaktivinoda Thakur pointing out, well, you can do it. You can show me? You can show? You cannot show. Even a single instance. When Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving an address or speaking something about Sahajya Bhajan, you can show? No. But still people speaking all rubbish. Jaiva Dharma, Chaitanya Siksha Amrita, Mahaprabhu Siksha. And now I speaking about the book. It's very important book, Bhakti Vinod, Bani Vaibhav. Those are most important books. If you go through those books, you can find the actual motive of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I also agree with you that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came here in this material planet to distribute the secret of bhajan. The secrecy of bhajan. And in Kirtan, in Sloka, we also find Nija bhajana mudram upadisam sa chaitanya kingme punarapidishwar yasvati padam sabhaktebhyo sudhyam nija bhajana mudram upadisam sa chaitanya kingme punarapidishwar yasvati padam. In Kirtan, Srinivasa is writing, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu can come in front of us out of his causeless mercy, he wanted to show us the secrecy of bhajan. He wanted to speak everything out of his character, out of his speech. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu always wanted to speak the secrecy of bhajan. But we are so foolish, we couldn't understand the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Before leaving this material world, Prabhupada was very sorry. Before leaving this material world, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada was very sorry. He told that I came here to speak something secrets of bhajan, secrets of bhajan. But I find nobody here to whom I can speak this. I am always speaking all preliminary things of bhajan, and my life is gone just now. I find I am going now. But I find not a single person to whom I can speak all this secrecy, Prabhupada told. Of course not about Guru Varga, he is speaking about us, common people. So it is good that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came here to speak all the secrecy of bhajan. If somebody can understand the character of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the Siddhanta of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu through one pure devotees, then you can know everything. You can get the complete teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You need not ask anybody, but this is very typical. Understand? Actually, all those bonded soul, we are here. We all are the representative of Kala Krishna Das. You know Kala Krishna Das? Prabhupada telling, those bonded soul, they are the representative of Kala Krishna Das. Who is Kala Krishna Das? But he is the representative of all bonded soul. Bonded soul, any time, any moment can fall down into Maya. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was there in his South India, in his South India tour, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was there in South India tour. Nobody was there. Only Kala Krishna Das was there. You think of it. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself there. But Kala Krishna Das, how is there any chance to fall down into Maya? No. But still he is going to enjoy woman. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going and catching his ear, come, pull. This way, Narottama Thakur singing kirtan. Ho Gurudev, ho Vaishnav, if you all come here and catch my ear and pull out of Maya, I am fallen into Maya, deep into Maya. In kirtan, you must do this kind of kirtan. There is translation, transcription is there. Kirtan, In Bengali it is a tobeshe dekhiye bhalo notuba paran gelo kahe dino Narottama Das. If you can save me, then I am saved. If you can pull me out of Maya, otherwise I am going to die. Narottama Thakur actually in Maya? In Maya? No. They are all teaching us. Actually, they are all teaching us. So you must do the kirtan of Narottama Thakur, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, always. Every time. If you can go to, if there is meaning of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, kirtan, all kirtan there. Is there any such book where there is interpretation of the meaning, purport of Bhaktivinoda Thakur kirtan? So you must read it. Very nice kirtan. So to get the actual teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we must follow those pure devotees. Others we cannot understand. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, so many documents are there. I have no time to speak. Maharaj coming within 5 minutes actually. There is written, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami written, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami speaking, Sri Chaitanya Madhupebhyo Namo Namaha. Sri Chaitanya Madhupebhyo Namo Namaha. Sri Chaitanya Madhupebhyo Namo Namaha. Kathanchit Asrayat Jesam Sa Upitat Gandabhag Bhavet. Those were honeybees
around the lotus feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Those were hovering around the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, lotus. They are always trying to get some honey. They are always trying to get some honey, nectar, from this lotus flower of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's lotus feet. So if we can take shelter of one such devotee, if you can shelter of one such devotee, then it's more than enough. You identify yourself as a man. What about man? Even a dog can get the address of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He can reach. What about man? If one dog get the smell of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's lotus feet, he can reach. We can know in Sivananda Sen, his dog. How Sivananda Sen dog going to transcendental world, you know, Vaikuntha. We already know. So there is no doubt. If he can have a great faith unto the lotus feet of pure Vaishnav, Shuddha Vaishnav, then be sure. First of all, we must eliminate all our desire and everything. All material desire inside our body and mind. We are in material platform. If I speak about rasa tatta, it's not good. It's not good actually. Because you are in material platform. According to your right, if you speak and hear, according to your right, if you speak and hear, is good actually. Then if you can go up. In Bhajan Rasa, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking all nice about this. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving all. Bhajan Rasa, if you have the translation of Bhajan Rasa, you can read daily. You can know. All secrecy of it. Very nice, actually. Otherwise, you cannot do actual bhajan. Nice. Many people, they are misinterpreting different tatha. Actually, if you go through Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami, Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you can get actual guidance. Otherwise, problem. Maharaj coming, so I finish here. If any question from you, because Maharaj coming, I feel anxiety inside. It's not good. Maharaj coming now, 1 month, 2 minutes, Maharaj coming. So if there is any question, you can put. If you can, I can relax and speak 5 hours, 4 hours, 2 hours. The tension of Maharaj coming. If there is any question, you can put. Any question? Demigods, they are all Sakama Bhakta. They are looking into this material world. What they see? Everything. That is their spiritual eyes. That is their spiritual eyes. By that spiritual eyes, they can see. They are not totally in. They are not totally material. They are doing bhakti. They have their faith for Krishna. They are devotee actually. Sakama Bhakti. They are doing bhakti. Actually, those who are demigods, what about demigods, those who are yogi, they have their special power. Actually, those who are demigods, they have some siddhi. Siddhi, you know, they can look from distance. They can hear from distance. They have their special power. That is already God gifted. Like on ghost. If one ghost, he can speak about your past life. He can speak. Because they are in fine body. They can speak. That's why they have their special power to see what is inside you. Anyway, Maharaj Kami.